Hi everyone, and welcome to Passionfroot, where we pursue lives of purpose together. So today is a bit of a different video, but today I'm going to be taking you with me to a very exciting location, a very, very fun... So today I'm going to be taking you guys with me on an adventure. I'm going to be taking you on an artist date with me. Normally I do a bit of a sit down and chat, but I'm over it, guys. I want to go places with you. I want to see the world. I am basically leaving behind all of my obligations for the day. I have washing to do. I have washing up to do. I have a table to clean, but I'm like, I'm not about that life. I'm done. I'm so tired and sick of it. So to refill my cup, my artist cup, I'm gonna go out, spend a few hours, and not take my laptop with me. Okay, we're good. Let's go for realsies this time. Literally all I can think about right now is food because I haven't had breakfast and it's like 10:30. What am I gonna eat? What am I gonna... Oh, so exciting. So, the last time I did an artist date, I went into the city, I went into the galleries and just had a lovely time kind of cafe hopping, walking around like the department stores and just, you know, seeing the sights of the city. And this time I was tempted to do that again, but I thought because summer is over, because the warm weather is nearly completely over. It is no longer summer here in Australia, and yet the warm weather is continuing. So I'm gonna take advantage of that and go to the beach. The last couple of weeks have really just been me sitting in front of a computer from like 7 a.m. till 7 p.m. every day. So it won't be a full day activity, unfortunately, because I do have to get back and do some work. Dread. But I figure, look, if I work for myself and I'm chained to a desk more than I would be than if I worked in an office, what is the point? So today is proof to myself that I can do this.
Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. I really hope this sound is gonna work. I just read this poem. That was beautiful. This poem is called I Have Decided. I have decided to find myself a home in the mountains, somewhere high up where one learns to live peacefully in the cold and the silence. It's said that in such a place, certain revelations may be discovered, that what the spirit reaches for may be eventually felt, if not exactly understood. Slowly, no doubt. I'm not talking about a vacation. Of course, at the same time, I mean to stay exactly where I am. Are you following me? It's so good. It's so good. It provokes action, it provokes thought, and it makes me want to live my life differently. I love it. It's Mary Oliver. I know at the very least that Darcie will understand because we are both Mary Oliver fans. So I have a poem bubbling up right now. No matter how twisted and warped my life becomes due to the thoughts that make it so, no matter how fast my legs run through the sandbanks of time, the waves will keep hitting the shore. The wind will keep blowing where it wants. Everything will be unfazed, building your sandcastle. Something like that. I don't know. It's a work in progress, clearly.
Okay, I was just about to pack up, put my books away, etc. And I noticed this. This is the back cover of Mary Oliver's book. This is why she is Mary Oliver and I am not. Get this. I go down to the shore in the morning and depending on the hour, the waves are rolling in or moving out and I say, oh, I am miserable. What should I do? And the sea says in its lovely voice, excuse me, I have work to do. That's exactly what I was feeling and saying before when I was writing my weird poem. But this is like... ugh. So I'm back. I've just spent about 2 hours sitting and writing and thinking and observing and eating and just being. Being. That's a good way to put it. I'm not a human doing. Well, I wasn't for 2 hours. I was actually a human being and that was really nice. But I wanted to read you what I wrote and I wanted to read it in the car to make sure that you could actually hear what I was saying because I know the audio is not great at the beach. My journaling technique is simply flow of consciousness, stream of consciousness, see what comes out. And I started by talking about how stressed I felt and then I ended with a bit of a call to my creativity, which I was not expecting. I'm gonna read it to you. How can I eliminate stress from my life? I am so tired of feeling overwhelmed and like I'm skimming the surface, only doing the bare necessities at the expense of self-care. I'm tired. Going above and beyond is my default setting. And when I don't, I feel guilty, unworthy of love. And so I warp reality so that this remains true. If I wake up with my hair all unruly and my clothes all creased, and my husband says, good morning, cutie, and gives me a big hug, I try to shrug him off because in my reality, I don't look like the quote unquote other girls, the girls that I hoped or expected to one day look like. And so I reject that love, admiration, or affection because it feels undeserved. Or if someone says, well done, you nailed it, after I finish a presentation or do something well professionally, but I feel like I haven't, then my brain will justify their words as lies. Ah, they must just be being nice to get me to like them or to make me feel better about myself, I say. When in actual fact, they may be being genuine. And at this point in my life, I've gotten incredibly good at this mind game of rejecting love before it has a chance to settle on my skin. I brush it off and say, oh, thanks, but it was insert flaw here. Or, oh, that's lovely coming from you, insert compliment about them here so I can deflect attention off myself. A lot of this behavior arises because I don't actively spend time telling myself that I am lovable and valuable simply because I exist. The older I get, and hopefully wiser, the more I realize that very few virtues happen by chance. We might be born with natural beauty or public speaking skills or a plethora of other wonderful talents, but unless we foster them, they will only take us so far. But the thing is, fostering is not only a physical act, something we do through repetition or practice, although that is important. I'll keep going. Hang on, another page. Fostering talents is also a mind game. We must also work to silence the voices that tell us to give up, that we're not good enough, that we'll never make it. Because what good is all the technical skill in the world if a pianist is too afraid to play in front of a crowd?
But also, what good is talent if the pianist never creates time to play because he believes that other things are more important? Because he doesn't take himself seriously or believe his craft is worthy of being invested in. This is all a mind game, and nothing is built by chance. There will always be inner demons or toxic thoughts that hold you back from your true potential. It's your job to silence them. There will always be urgent events or commitments vying for your time. It's your job to put them in their rightful place, second in line to your own self-care and creativity. As the artist, the most important thing that you must create before anything else is time. Because life should not be a busy blur, skimming the surface. It should be a grand and colorful adventure where you call the shots in God's perfect timing. The end. Mic drop. I do realize now that this was actually a bit of a glorified journaling session, but that's what my heart needed today. I needed to get some stuff onto the paper, onto the page. And quite honestly, I'm very surprised with what came out. It does feel like someone else wrote it. It doesn't feel like I wrote it, even though I did, which is this really weird phenomenon that I often experience when I spend time with God or when I journal and write down my thoughts. It's as though there's like this inner knowing, maybe the Holy Spirit, this like force, this wisdom that I'm not conscious of day to day, but then when I actually quieten everything and spend the time to engage with it, it tells me the most beautiful things, and I cannot explain that, and I don't know if any of you have experienced it. If you have, please let me know in the comments below, because it is weird and amazing and the most life-giving, love-giving thing. My words don't even like cover what I'm trying to say. If you're feeling like you're skimming the surface, if you're busy, if you're just like, if that's how your life feels right now, take a couple of hours. It doesn't take long. It literally was like 2 or 3 hours out of my day today. And just connect with yourself, check in with yourself, get a bigger perspective. Get out in nature, especially, is helpful. But just realize that your problems aren't actually that big, your deadlines aren't actually that important, and there's way more to life than your schedule. Basically, I very much condone artist dates, and you should do one. You should really do one. Anyway, I'm going to drive home now. I'm going to do all the things I have to do, but I'm going to do it in a much more relaxed state of mind, which is very good. Love you all so much. Thank you for watching, and let's keep growing together. Bye.